My question today is, as humans, we tend to tell white lies and get out of the situations that we don't like to be in. Does that affect our karma?
Beta, there's a saying, every penny makes a pound. So, beta, everything that we do is going to create positivity or negativity. And at the ending of the day, the sum total of your karmas creates your destiny. So why would I do something which is going to enhance that negativity in my mind? Because whatever you do, you say, it's going to create a certain impression on your mind, beta. And if, even unconsciously, we are sort of doing something wrong, you're creating a negative impression on your mind, beta. And when all these things add up, today it might just be a small thing. But when it starts adding up, it can put a lot of pressure.
Te Baba ji, jitna hun ahi sare jane matlab bahar aaye ha, matlab jehde itthe India te chalo theek hai, jaane ya nathokar vajdi, satsang sunde ho, mahol banda. Par Baba ji, itthe joban de prati oh mahol nahi banda hi, oh mahol kiddan banayi vi jehda ahi 24 ghante us satgur di yaad de vich rahi.
Beta, mahol insaan khud bananda hai, koi hor nahi bananda. ਮਾਹੌਲ ਕੋਈ ਇੱਟਾਂ ਪੱਥਰਾਂ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਨਹੀਂ ਬਣਦਾ, ਇਨਸਾਨ ਬਣਾਉਂਦਾ ਹੈਗਾ ਬੇਟਾ। ਸੋ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਵੀ ਆਪਾਂ ਜਾਵਾਂਗੇ, ਜੇ ਆਪਣੀ ਸੋਚ ਸਹੀ ਰਹੂਗੀ, ਆਪਾਂ ਉਹਦੇ ਭਾਣੇ ਉਹਦੇ ਹੁਕਮ ਵਿੱਚ ਰਹਿਣ ਦੀ ਕੋਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਕਰਾਂਗੇ। ਈਸਾ ਮਸੀਹ ਨੇ ਵੀ ਬਾਈਬਲ ਵਿੱਚ ਕਿਹਾ ਸੀ ਕਿ ਵੇਅਰ ਦੇਰ ਆਰ ਟੂ ਸਿਟਿੰਗ ਇਨ ਮਾਈ ਨੇਮ ਦੇਰ ਆਈ ਐਮ, ਕਿ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਵੀ ਦੋ ਮੇਰੀ ਯਾਦ ਵਿੱਚ ਬੈਠੇ ਆ ਉੱਥੇ ਹੀ ਉਹ ਹੈਗੇ ਆ। ਸੋ ਮਾਲਿਕ ਤਾਂ ਬੇਟਾ ਆਪਣੇ ਅੰਗ ਸੰਗ ਹੈ। ਸੋ ਇਹ ਤਾਂ ਸਾਡਾ ਨਜ਼ਰੀਆ ਹੈ ਨਾ, ਜਿਵੇਂ ਸਾਈਂ ਬੁੱਲੇ ਸ਼ਾਹ ਨੇ ਕਿਹਾ ਸੀ, ਉਹ ਸ਼ਾਹ ਅਸਾਂ ਤੋਂ ਵੱਖ ਨਹੀਂ, ਬਿਨ ਸ਼ਾਹ ਦਾ ਦੂਜਾ ਕੱਖ ਨਹੀਂ, ਪਰ ਵੇਖਣ ਵਾਲੀ ਅੱਖ ਨਹੀਂ।
ਬਾਬਾ ਜੀ, ਕੀ ਡਿਜ਼ਾਇਰਲੈਸ ਮੈਡੀਟੇਸ਼ਨ ਪੋਸੀਬਲ ਹੈ ਜੀ ਮਨ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਜੀ?
ਉਹ ਲਕਸ਼ ਹੈ ਬੇਟਾ ਆਪਣਾ, ਨਿਸ਼ਕਾਮ ਕਰਮਾ ਉਹ ਲਕਸ਼ ਹੈ ਇਸ ਵਕਤ ਬੇਟਾ। ਦੇਖੋ, ਮੈਂ ਬੇਨਤੀ ਕੀਤੀ ਨਾ ਕਿ ਸਾਰਾ ਕੁਛ ਜ਼ਰੂਰਤ ਤੋਂ ਸ਼ੁਰੂ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ, ਠੀਕ ਹੈ। ਹੁਣ ਚਾਹਤ ਤੋਂ, ਹੁਣ ਜੇ ਭਾਵੇਂ ਮਾਲਕ ਦੀ ਚਾਹਤ ਹੈ, ਉਹ ਵੀ ਤਾਂ ਚਾਹਤ ਹੀ ਹੈ। ਮੈਂ ਭਜਨ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਕਰਾਂ, ਉਹ ਵੀ ਤਾਂ ਚਾਹਤ ਹੀ ਹੈ। ਮੈਂ ਸਾਫ਼ ਸੁਥਰਾ ਰਹਾਂ, ਆਪਣੇ ਮਾਂ ਬਾਪ ਦੀ ਸੇਵਾ ਕਰ ਸਕਾਂ, ਉਹ ਵੀ ਤਾਂ ਚਾਹਤ ਹੀ ਹੈ ਨਾ। ਸੋ ਇਸ ਅਵਸਥਾ ਵਿੱਚ ਚਾਹ ਹੋਊਗੀ, ਉਹ ਲਕਸ਼ ਹੈ। ਆਹਿਸਤਾ ਆਹਿਸਤਾ ਆਪਾਂ ਉਸ ਲਕਸ਼ ਦੀ ਤਰਫ ਵਧਣਾ ਹੈ, ਜਿੱਥੇ ਆਪਾਂ ਸਿਰਫ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਚੀਜ਼ਾਂ ਦੇ ਹਿਸਾਬ ਕਿਤਾਬ ਵਿੱਚ ਨਾ ਰੱਖੀਏ। ਆਪਾਂ ਜੋ ਵੀ ਐਕਸ਼ਨ ਲੈਂਦੇ ਹਾਂ, ਉਹ ਐਕਸ਼ਨ ਲੈਣ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਕਦਮ ਚੁੱਕੀਏ, ਬਜਾਏ ਇਹਦੇ ਕਿ ਇਹਦੇ ਵਿੱਚੋਂ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਹਾਸਲ ਕੀ ਹੋਊਗਾ। ਇਸ ਵਕਤ ਗਿਣਤੀ ਹੋਊਗੀ।
ਅਤੇ ਬਾਬਾ ਜੀ, ਚਾਹਤ ਫਿਰ ਪੋਜ਼ਿਟਿਵ ਕਿਹੜੀ ਚਾਹਤ ਮਤਲਬ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਰੱਖੀਏ ਜੀ?
ਜਿਹੜੀ ਚੀਜ਼ ਮਾਲਕ ਦੇ ਤਰਫ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਹੈ, ਜਿਹੜੀ ਮਾਲਕ ਤੋਂ ਦੂਰ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਹੈ, ਆਪਾਂ ਖੜੂ ਉਹਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਪੈਣਾ ਬੇਟਾ।
ਹਮ 4 ਵਾਓਜ਼ ਲੈਤੇ ਹੈ ਜਬ ਨਾਮ ਨਾਲ ਮਿਲਤਾ ਹੈ, ਉਸਮੇ ਸੇ ਇੱਕ ਐਲਕੋਹਲ ਕਾ ਹੋਤਾ ਹੈ, ਐਲਕੋਹਲ ਔਰ ਮਾਇੰਡ ਆਲਟਰਿੰਗ ਡਰੱਗਸ। ਅਬ ਕਿਤਨੇ ਲੋਕ ਯਹਾਂ ਪੇ ਦਵਾਈਆਂ ਲੈਤੇ ਹੈ, ਜੈਸੇ ਇੱਕ ਐਲਪ੍ਰੈਕਸ ਕੀ ਗੋਲੀ ਯਹਾਂ ਪੇ ਸਭਕੋ ਪਤਾ ਹੋਗਾ, ਮੋਸਟਲੀ ਲੋਕ ਲੈਤੇ ਹੈ। ਮੇਰੀ ਮੰਮੀ ਜੋ ਹੈ ਵੋ ਕੋਈ ਜ਼ਰਾ ਸੀ ਟੈਨਸ਼ਨ ਹੋ ਜਾਏ ਜਾਂ ਨੀਂਦ ਨਹੀਂ ਆ ਰਹੀ, ਐਲਪ੍ਰੈਕਸ ਕੀ ਗੋਲੀ ਲੈ ਲਈ, ਤੋ ਮੈਂ ਹਮੇਸ਼ਾ ਬੋਲਦੀ ਹੂੰ ਕਿ ਇਟਸ ਇਕੁਅਲ ਟੂ 1 ਗਲਾਸ ਔਫ ਵਾਈਨ, ਮੀਨ 1 ਗਲਾਸ ਔਫ ਵਾਈਨ ਵੀ ਉਸੇ ਕਮ ਹੋਗੀ ਜਿਤਨੀ ਵੋ ਗੋਲੀ ਕਾ, ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਮੈਂ ਫਾਰਮੇਸੀ ਮੈਂ ਹੂੰ ਤੋ ਮੁਝੇ ਪਤਾ ਹੈ ਇਟਸ ਐਲਪ੍ਰੋਲਿਜ਼ਮ ਜੋ ਵੋ ਐਨਜ਼ਾਇਟੀ ਔਰ ਡਿਪਰੈਸ਼ਨ ਕੇ ਲੀ ਹੋਤੀ ਹੈ, ਤੋ ਆਪ ਉਸਕੇ ਉੱਪਰ ਕਲੈਰੀਫਿਕੇਸ਼ਨ ਦੇ ਦੋ। ਮੰਮੀ ਕਹਤੀ ਐਸਾ ਕੁਛ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੋਤਾ, ਐਸਾ ਕੁਛ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੋਤਾ ਹੈ।
ਬੇਟਾ ਦੇਖੋ, ਐਸੇ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਦਵਾਈਓ ਕਾ ਜੋ ਬੇਸ ਹੈ ਵੋ ਐਲਕੋਹਲ ਰੱਖਤੇ ਹੈ ਉਨਕੋ ਪ੍ਰਿਜ਼ਰਵ ਕਰਨੇ ਕੇ ਲੀਏ, ਮਗਰ ਉਸਮੇ ਜਿਤਨੀ ਐਲਕੋਹਲ ਹੋਤੀ ਹੈ ਵੋ ਬਹੁਤ ਕਮ ਹੋਤੀ ਹੈ, ਵੋ ਸਿਰਫ ਐਜ਼ ਅ ਪ੍ਰੈਜ਼ਰਵੇਟਿਵ, ਉਸਕੇ ਸਾਥ ਦਿਮਾਗ ਕੋ ਕੋਈ ਇਫੈਕਟ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੋਤਾ, ਵੋ ਦਵਾਈ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਕੋਈ ਉਲਟੇ ਕਾਮ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਰੇਗਾ। ਸੋ ਵਹਾਂ ਤੱਕ ਸੀਮਿਤ ਰਹੇਗੇ, ਠੀਕ ਹੈ। ਡਾਕਟਰ ਨੇ ਦਵਾਈ ਦੀ ਹੈ, ਕੋਈ ਦੇਖ ਕੇ ਦੀ ਹੈ, ਵੋ ਲੈ ਸਕਤੇ ਹੈ, ਇਹ ਠੀਕ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਇਹ ਜੋ ਚੀਜ਼ੇ ਹੈ ਜੋ ਹਮ ਡਾਕਟਰ ਕੇ ਕਹੇ ਬਗੈਰ ਹੀ ਲੈਣਾ ਸ਼ੁਰੂ ਕਰ ਦੇਤੇ ਹੈ, ਵੋ ਹਮੇ ਅਵੋਇਡ ਕਰਨੀ ਚਾਹੀਏ। ਕੋਈ ਵੀ ਚੀਜ਼ ਅਬ ਕਿਸੀ ਵੀ ਚੀਜ਼ ਪੇ ਆਪ ਐਕਸਟ੍ਰੀਮ ਪੇ ਜਾਓਗੇ ਤੋ ਉਸਕਾ ਰਿਐਕਸ਼ਨ ਹੋਗਾ ਬੇਟਾ। ਸੋ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਸਾ ਬੈਲੈਂਸ ਰੱਖ ਕੇ, ਅਗਰ ਕੋਈ ਪ੍ਰੋਬਲਮ ਹੈ, ਡਾਕਟਰ ਦਵਾਈ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਹੈ, ਬੜੀ ਖੁਸ਼ੀ ਸੇ ਲੇ, ਮਗਰ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਸੈਲਫ ਮੈਡੀਕੇਸ਼ਨ ਕਰਨਾ ਸ਼ੁਰੂ ਕਰ ਦੇ ਔਰ ਉਸਕੀ ਆਦਤ ਪੜ ਜਾਏ, तो वो सही नहीं होता।
थैंक यू बाबा जी।
बाबा जी अक्सर जिदा तुसीं कहंदे हो कि भी किस्मत जो किस्मत लिखा हुंदा वो मिलता, इदां भी हुंदा कि भी समटाइम सानू जो जिहड़ा बंदा साडी किस्मत च आंदा जां साडी लाइफ च आंदा कि भी उहदे करके सानू कुछ मिल रहा।
बेटा किस्मत अपनी है, दूजे की किस्मत का थोनों नहीं मिल सकता। थोनों की पता कि पहला ही नहीं लिखा गया थोड़ी किस्मत वो दे आना।
जो साड़ी कोई लाइफ दे विच अगर बंदा आया वो दे आन दे तो बाद साड़ी लाइफ चेंज हो गई होगी कि भी इदा होगा।
थोनों कैसे पता कि पहला तो किस्मत नहीं लिखा सी, वो थोनों तो अपनी किस्मत का पता नहीं ना बेटा। किस्मत बनी है कर्मा दे नाल, कर्म थोड़े है, सो किस्मत नहीं बदल सकती बेटा, वो कोई गलती नहीं करता।
माय क्वेश्चन इज व्हेनेवर आई एम सिटिंग फॉर भजन सिमरन, इफ यू कुड गाइड मी लिटिल बिट हाउ टू फोकस ऑन थर्ड आई इफेक्टिवली टू कंसंट्रेट मोर।
बेटा द नेचुरल इंक्लिनेशन यू नो इज एट द आई सेंसर। Hazur used to explain it that you take a magnet and put an iron piece, it's just going to get pulled by the magnet. So similarly, this is our magnet out here. So the natural inclination of the surut or the consciousness is to the eye center. But that consciousness is weighed down because of our karmas. You know? So you put that iron piece which goes towards the magnet, if you put some weight on top of it, it will become slower. You put more weight, it only moves. You put more weight, it stops moving also. So similarly, because we are weighed down by our karmas, but as we keep on removing that weight, it is naturally inclined. So through Simran, we are trying to collect our attention and to focus so that we take our consciousness away from the karmic weight towards, so you don't have to do anything. You just keep your attention here, do your simran, and it will automatically start getting pulled towards that. So you just need to keep your attention there and it will automatically find its place.
Radha Swami Babaji, this is a three-part question on the bhajan posture. The first part of the question is the position of the thumb. We were told at initiation to use the right thumb to close the right opening of the right ear. So is it the tip of the thumb or the soft part of the thumb or any part of the any finger?
Just lightly. Basically to protect outside sounds from interfering. So very lightly. If you put too much pressure, then the ear will start paining or your thumb will start paining, throbbing. So very lightly you are supposed to close it.
Second part of the question, Babaji, is related to the first question, the degree of pressure. From experience, pressure too light, we get distracted by external sound. If it's too much, we can hear the physical sound of the blood circulating in the head. So what's the optimal
pressure?
That's only initially.
Yeah, you're right. If you sort of press too hard, you'll feel the throbbing. But eventually you will see that the throbbing will stop and you will be able to focus.
Third part of the question, Babaji, we were taught Sanmat is a spiritual science, but there is some emphasis on the physicality of the bhajan posture. As an analogy, I'm a Tai Chi practitioner. To contribute to the success of Tai Chi, we were taught in Tai Chi school, the physical posture of Tai Chi contributes only 10% to the success, the breathing 20%, mind control is 70%. So in the bhajan posture, there's some emphasis on closing the right ear, opening the left ear, but we also thought that the sound is from everywhere. So how important, how many percent is the importance of the physical posture of bhajan?
You see, physical posture is, like I said, mind works by association. So, and since the mind is not in our control, we are trying to create a positive atmosphere and associate everything with focusing at the eye center. You know, so it's like when you see people in athletics sprinting, they take a certain position, right? Now, it's not that they can't stand up and sprint also, they can. But that position gives them a little bit of a head start. So initially, that posture is important. Eventually, you should be able to hear the sound 24 hours of the day. So at the moment, it is our limitation that we can't hear the sound. It's not that the sound is not there. Without the sound, you won't live. Because sound is that creative power. So the sound is there in your entire body. But since we have the load of karmas that covering, so we are not able to hear it properly. So through the meditative process, we are trying to focus and go beyond the physical and be able to hear that sound. And eventually with practice, I mean, you could be standing there talking to me and hearing the sound. Then nothing is necessary.
Thank you, Babaji.
Master, we are taught that we should hear the sound from the right. But ultimately, the sound is from above. I want to know, is the sound from above divided into three parts, left, center, and right? If this is so, could I listen to the sound from the left of the above at the eye center? Thank you, Babaji.
So as I was explaining to the brother, the sound is there in our entire body. You know, if the Lord withdraws the sound from any part of the body, that part of the body will stop functioning. So it is that creative power. Now we need to focus it at the eye center. You know, it's like the sun's ray and the warmth is given to the entire creation. But if you take a magnifying glass, you can channelize that and that gives you energy. So similarly, we are trying to channelize at the eye center. So don't analyze the left and right. Just focus at the eye center and try and listen. And automatically it will start centering. Now most of us, because we are told of this left and right, so you know our attention is to the left, thinking that is coming from the left. You keep your attention at the eye center and it will center by itself.
Dear Master, I donate regularly and I transfer the money to charity. They use the donated money to buy or to make food for homeless people. I'm sure that the money I donate is used for food and clothing for the homeless. But probably there's some meat in the food. That means I unintentionally pay for the meat consumed. Should I continue donating or I should stop it? Thank you, Babaji.
Well, sister, there are two aspects to this. Whenever you donate, we should never judge, you know. But on the other side, yes, we are becoming part of a chain, you know, because you've given money, that money was sort of used to buy food, and that food, if it was non-vegetarian, then some animal lost his or her life for satisfaction of that need. So I'm sure there are lots of charities in your country which
yes.
could be just giving clothes or doing other support. So you can donate to them. Try and not become part of any chain that causes pain or suffering.
Thank you, Babaji. Firstly, in the physical, you are my master. From the spiritual point of view, you are God, and I am God too. There are no worldly relations. There is no master, disciple, no brother, sister, no parents, no satsang, only God, but also no God, Is it right? If this is true, should I be necessary for me to meditate every day? Thank you.
You see, today, God is a concept for us. We haven't seen Him, and therefore, somebody, our religions or some scriptures have told us about this entity that we call God. Until you don't feel, until you don't see, until you don't experience, how do you know what the reality is? Now, you stand outside, you look on top, you can see one sun. On the ground, you see thousands and millions of different rays of light. So what is the reality? At a lower level of consciousness, we see ourselves separated because of the physical. But on top, there is only one sun. The sun can stay without the ray of light. The ray of light cannot stay without the sun. So we are all dependent on that one. We are projections of that one. In the six scriptures, Guru Sahib says, Atam me Ram, Ram me Atam, Chinas Guru Vichara. That in the soul is the Lord, and the Lord is in the soul, but few have been able to realize it. So today for us, the physical is the reality. Until we go within, and we don't get the spiritual experience, you know, we don't even realize our own soul, for that matter. And once you go beyond the physical, physical is a limitation. What we are seeking is unlimited. When you go into the spiritual realm, that is unlimited, that helps you to experience the divine. And then you know who God is. So it's an experience.
My question is, when I do Simran, I put my attention in the eye center because I should repeat the five names. So I need to put some attention in repeating five names consciously or unconsciously at the same time. That means I should pay attention into two parts. One is eye center and the other is five names. Is that correct? Or should I just pay attention at the eye center?
You see, to start with, because we are not in that habit, we have to use our tongue to repeat. But once you do it on a regular basis, you know, it's like if you've gone to a party late night somewhere and there was a song which kept on playing again and again, you get up in the morning and without even consciously trying to remember, that song is going on in your mind. So similarly, today the tongue, you are consciously trying to repeat the Simran. But at some stage, as we acquire that habit, the mind will pick it up. And when the mind picks up the Simran, then the mind is going to repeating it, the tongue doesn't even need to move. And when the mind starts repeating it, then the focus will take place. Because it is the mind that causes the distractions. So if the mind picks up the Simran, then there's no distraction. So that is something we are all working towards. That's why we are told that apart from our meditation, even during the day when we have time, do your Simran. So the mind picks it up. And when the mind picks it up, then you will be very focused. So put your attention. And the eye center, it's the natural inclination of the consciousness towards the eye center. So as you get focused, automatically the attention will start going there.
Thank you, Babaji.